James Gordon Clark Dodge was born on 9 February 1840 in Boston, Suffolk County, Massachusetts as the first child of Joshua Cleves Dodge and Jane Maria Clark. He was also the fifth great-grandson of our immigrant forefather William Farmer Dodge Sr. and his wife Elizabeth Cox, who were my ninth great-grandparents. James, though a young man, had shown himself to be possessed of unusual energy and rare decision of character. Born in Boston, in the year 1840, he lost his father in 1853, when James was 13 years old. He was taken to Europe by his mother and educated in France, and for several years was a resident of Brussels. From his experience in French schools, he acquired an ineradicable dislike for the French people and their character, which seemed to increase as he grew older and became more acquainted with and fond of his native country. An ardent love for his native land was perhaps the most striking characteristic of the man, which was doubtless intensified by his abhorrence of all that was foreign. He arrived back in Boston, Massachusetts in the steamship America on November 5, 1858 from Liverpool, England at the age of 17. He completed his education at the newly formed Lawrence Scientific School at Harvard University, so named for the industrialist and entrepreneur Abbot Lawrence, who donated $50,000 in unprecedented sum in 1847 to create the institution. After completing his studies, he traveled through the northern states. Then on July 18, 1859, James appears on page one of the then Boston Post in an article written by one of their correspondents, who at that time was at the Profile House, which was located in the White Mountains of New Hampshire in Franconia Notch. In this article the writer quotes a saying, "You can't keep a hotel," and then, in great detail, explains the in and outs of running a hotel tavern. He fully describes the pitfalls of the present-day hotels, such as maintenance, staffing, food preparation, and the most important objective, trying to squeeze out a profit. After his lengthy explanations, he concluded his article with the following words: "To those who live by the salt water, nothing can be better than the change of air and scenery of the mountains inland. Well, my dear Post, I commenced this letter to say something about the mountains and the people who are here, and have turned off, all unconsciously, into a disquisition on taverns and tavern keepers. So you must wait till another time for the execution of the purpose by which I was first inspired to write you, and now let me close by telling your Boston readers that among the residents of the modern Athens now in the mountain regions are J. M. Manning, James G. C. Dodge, M. L. Reed, George R. Stetson, B. R. Keith and the Mrs. Stetson, and the striking beauty of profile, of the youngers of whom it would give me joy to describe and attest, did I not fear to offend her, and excite the jealousy of other." So James G. C. Dodge hits the newspaper just months after arriving back to the United States. Here is a little history lesson on the origins of the Profile House. In 1852, when Richard Taft and his company, the Flume and Franconia Hotel Company, bought the Lafayette House at the north end of the Notch, construction began on the first Profile House, and it opened in 1853, a simple 3.5-story building. It was expanded several times, by the addition of first one wing and then another. The Profile House, in Franconia Notch, existed for 70 years. The first Profile House opened in 1853 and the new Profile burned in 1923. At the time of its destruction, it could accommodate 500 guests, and was the most luxurious hotel on the west side of the mountains. The parking lot for the Cannon Mountain ski area and tramway now covers the site where the hotel once stood. The American Civil War, also known as the War Between the States or simply the Civil War, was a civil war fought from 1861 to 1865 between the United States, the Union or the North, and several southern slave states that declared their secession and formed the Confederate States of America, the Confederacy or the South. The war had its origin in the issue of slavery, especially the extension of slavery into the Western territories. James Dodge was an unqualified loyalist to the Constitution and Union of the United States, and was unwavering in his support of the federal government in their efforts for the suppression of the rebellion, It was for those reasons he joined the 19th Regiment of the Massachusetts Volunteers on August 22, 1861. He was mustered into Company F as a non-commission, his rank second lieutenant, James G. C. Dodge, of Boston. His military career was recorded in many publications, such as books and newspaper articles, one of which was the History of the 19th Regiment, cover page shown on the left, where he was mentioned in 26 pages. The following accounts were taken from these pages. James was formally commissioned as second lieutenant by the following special order from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, headquarters, Boston, August 27, 1861. The 19th Regiment was organized at Camp School Linfield, Massachusetts. The new officers went earnestly to work drilling the regiment and getting the men acquainted with the musket, which would be of great benefit to them in later years. On the 28th of August 1861 at about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, the regiment was formed in a line. They then were presented with the state colors. A dress parade was then called, the last one in camp, and the regiment, 791 in numbers, filled on board the wagon trains, already waiting at the side of the campgrounds. Hasty farewells were said, and the train slowly headed to Boston, where a great crowd greeted it. The 19th formed at Boston Commons for a brief rest. They then marched to Old Colony Depot, taking the train and the Fall River Line and boats to New York. They were now off to war. The 19th Massachusetts Infantry arrived in Washington on August 30, 1861. It was stationed in Maryland, along the Upper Potomac. Then in October, it was assigned to Lander's Brigade in Stone Sedgwick's Division, Army of the Potomac, for operations along the Potomac. On October 21, 1861, while attached to Brigadier General Charles Stone's division, in the 1st Brigade under Brigadier General Frederick W. Landers, the 19th Regiment commanded by Colonel Edward Hinks. They were involved in their first actions at a battle known as Ball's Bluff. In a letter to Brigadier General William Schuyler, Adjutant General in Boston, Colonel Hinks wrote the following: "The 19th Regiment did not lose a man in the Battle of the 21st at Ball's Bluff. The circumstances surrounding the Battle of Ball's Bluff was covered in a movie produced as a fourth segment of the Northern Virginia Regional Parks, also known as NVRP, and produced by Fairfax County Government Television and narrated by Roger Mudd. The film is currently airing on the aforementioned cable network, and is also available via the Park Authority. Visit www.nvrpa.org for more information." After the showing of this movie, which highlights the day-long battle that took place at Ball's Bluff, I will present what happened during the night after the battle, in which Lieutenant James G.C. Dodge had a major role in.